Welcome to Sun City News. I'm your host, Norma Taylor, and it is great to be back in the studio reporting on what's happening here in Sun City. Well, here are some of the stories we're covering for you for this week. Our news team was at the Memorial Day commemorations. Our Sun City Car Club honored our area healthcare workers during Hospital Week. Those stories and more are coming up. Sun City News starts now.
From our studios in Pinckney Hall, this is Sun City News with Norma Taylor. Entertainment news with Randy Selman. Sports with Doug Wright. And the entire Sun City News team covering your community and the South Carolina Lowcountry.
The Community Association offices will be closed on Friday, July 3rd, for the holiday. While the Memorial Day commemoration by our Sun City Veterans Association was small and subdued this year, it achieved its purpose in recognizing the dedication and service of our fallen military.
In our current reality, we have been immersed in making sacrifices to keep ourselves protected. Here on Memorial Day, our Sun City Veterans Association is reminding us to look at the past, at the ultimate sacrifices that were made by those in military service.
Historically, the Veterans Association has always conducted a ceremony on Memorial Day. Normally, it's inside Magnolia Hall due to weather considerations at this time of year. We knew that we could not do that this year, so we had tentatively scripted up a small outdoors, brief, to the point ceremony just to make sure that we do honor those fallen veterans. There are three important days for service members. The first is Armed Forces Day, which is the third Saturday in May, to honor those actively serving now. Then we have Memorial Day, the last Monday of the month, which honors the fallen service members that went down in one of America's many wars. And then finally we have Veterans Day, the 11th of November, that honors all veterans, current and past.
Veterans, present her!
Anything else you'd like to share?
I just appreciate you all coming out here. I appreciate the Community Association giving us an opportunity to do this in a restrained way. And happy Memorial Day to all.
Over 30 members of the Sun City Car Club participated in a car club parade to recognize our area healthcare workers during Hospital Week. Their convoy traveled to Coastal Carolina Hospital, Bluffton Okeechobee Outpatient Center, Bluffton Medical Center, and Tidewatch Emergency Department. The parade was met with enthusiastic response from our healthcare heroes. Returning to Sun City, the overwhelming response was, "Glad we got a chance to do this. We'd like to do even more."
Here we are coming into our last stop, the closest one to home, the Tidewatch Emergency Department. We've been there for us so many times.
When we come back, the Sun City Veterans Association hands out restaurant cards. Reporter Chris Chase checks out the new installation of offices at GFWC. So don't go away. We'll be right back after these important messages. Our news team caught up with the Sun City Veterans Association as they distributed restaurant gift cards to member veterans as part of the Help for Hope effort in response to the closing of restaurants due to the COVID-19 crisis. Let's listen.
I'm with Tom DeGassi, who's the commander of the Sun City Veterans Association. And today you're sponsoring the Help for Hope restaurant gift cards. What's that about, Tom?
Well, Help for Hope initiative got started in Bluffton by a Watterson Family Foundation. They did some fundraising, raised over $250,000, teamed up with organizations like Bluffton Self-Help that would get people to come in that need something. They would do the vetting. Watterson's would give them the card. And the card is good for, it's worth $50 in food only, nothing else. For a takeout meal, they have a menu specifically for the $50 card. There's several variations of meal for four that you can pick up and take with you. Other places use it more just as a gift card. You order off the menu and you get $50 for the credit. So they came to us and said, are there any needy vets at Sun City? And I said, well, I don't think we've got many needy vets, but we have a lot of vets. And so they said, yes, if you can make sure that the cards get distributed to veterans in Sun City, they gave me 150 cards, and here we are today getting rid of the last of them. Yeah, we've worked with the Watterson Family Foundation for a little bit and tried to spread the word here that people could go in and donate online to buy cards for the needy folks. So they came back and said, okay, appreciate what you did to spread the word. Now here's what we can do to get back.
Okay. Well, my husband's a vet from Vietnam, so I look forward to that meal, Tom.
Very good. Did he come through?
Yep.
Okay, very good. Yeah.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Yeah.
With Rick Taylor. And Rick, you just received a restaurant card. What are your plans for that card?
Oh, it would be nice if after the next year. Really, really thanks a lot to the Veterans Association for doing this.
And who are you going to take?
I think I'm going to take you. My wife.
Good choice. Thank you.
There was a changing of the guard at the General Federation Women's Club this month. The over 125-year-old club has a new president and board. Reporter Chris Chase was there to talk to Phyllis Sipple, the new president.
We're here for the GFWC's inauguration of its new president and board members. Let's go interview Phyllis.
Bells ring to announce important events such as the end of the old year and the beginning of the new. Today, bells will symbolize the beginning of a new club year for us. Your new officers will assume positions of leadership, not only in the club, but in our community. For you have all indicated by your membership that you are willing to serve others. By serving, you will shape the future promise of our communities. These bells should serve to remind you, the members and officers, of your responsibility to support your leaders in the coming years. These bells will call you to serve your club, your community, and GFWC, and hopefully they will be rung in celebration of your achievements.
We are determined to have our September 17th meeting, even if it's by Zoom. So, and we're just going forward. Our challenge, I believe, is to maintain membership, but simultaneously, we obviously want to grow it. We have a lot of need in our community of Beaufort and Jasper County, and we have the talent and the wherewithal to do what we can do to support these groups, and we intend to accomplish that.
Well, that's excellent. I know you've got some great ideas. So we're going to get back to you later when things get more back to normal.
That I would appreciate very much.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Still to come on Sun City News, Randy Selman checks out walking in her entertainment report. And after a long off season, Doug Wright is back with a sports report and takes a look at what has happened since early March on the sports scene. We'll return after some messages from our sponsors. Now, let's check in with Randy Selman for an entertainment report.
Although we are still not able to enjoy all the wonderful entertainment and events here in Sun City, there are still ways to keep yourself both entertained and safe. I spent a lot of our downtime walking. Every day, my husband and I would find new streets to explore and different routes that would eventually lead us back to our house.
Let me tell you, we must have walked at least 3 to 4 miles every day. We binged on so many different television programs and movies. We talked a lot with our children, and our children happened to come down for the summers. We were able to see our grandchildren. And we also reconnected with a lot of neighbors that we haven't seen. We talked, of course, practicing social distancing. We spent some time in Publix with our masks and gloves, and that's what we did.
However, after a few weeks, I decided to branch out and explore some of the great nature walks right here in Sun City. To start my quest, I met a friend at Lake Somerset. Although not a traditional nature walk, we did walk the path around the lake. Then she took me on a trip through some of the paths across the street from the lake to check out some bluebird nests. What an adventure to see the tiny eggs in the nests, and it inspired me to maybe join the bird club. Another trail I traveled was named the Green Route off of Colonel Thomas Hayward Road. It's approximately 1¾ miles round trip. This I traveled with my 3-year-old grandson. Although we didn't see any wildlife, except maybe spiders, we had such a nice time walking and chatting about animals, bugs, and of course, alligators. I also took my grandson to a nature trail outside Sun City. It is called the Cypress Wetland Loop. It is a lightly traveled trail located near Port Royal, South Carolina, that offers a chance to see wildlife. And boy, did we see wildlife. We were first greeted by hundreds of birds, egrets, herons, wood storks, and a family of mallards, all part of a very large rookery. My grandson was especially in heaven after we spotted 2 giant black snakes. There were turtles galore and so many different plants. I mentioned that the only thing we didn't see was an alligator. And no sooner had I spoken the words, we spotted an alligator splashing in the swampy water. The trail is primarily used for walking, nature trips, and bird watching, and is best used from April until October. Dogs are also able to use this trail, but must be kept on a leash. So take a walk on the wild side. You'll be glad you did. I'm Randy Selman, and that's my entertainment report. Remember, life is entertaining, so don't miss the show.
Well, now Doug Wright joins us with what's happening in sports.
We may not say it every day, but it's clear that sports comprise a very important part in the lifestyle of Sun City residents. Whether you are a participant in competitive sports, working out to keep fit, or just being a spectator, we all are affected, and even more so when we experience the absence of sports. Many activities have now resumed, and we visited the sports park to check out the renovations and improvements. Okay, we're talking to Dave Eilers, a pickleball player who is enjoying some of the new facilities. And Dave, tell us what's new out here and what's your reaction?
I have to say everything's looking real well. We've got the 2 new pickleball courts here on the south side, the new volleyball net, and all the bocce courts, parking, and all the for golf carts and cars. So it's a great improvement considering from what it was before. And also then on the north side, you've got 4 new courts on the north side. So it's all good. We appreciate the Del Webb and the board for everything that they've done.
Well, Dave, thank you. Don't go away. I was going to ask you, you said bocce, but I'm sure you meant horseshoes over here. That's all right. And basically, it's a big advantage, I think, to have the parking off the streets.
Exactly.
So that's not clogged up. And these will be open shortly. How long have you been playing pickleball?
Probably about 4 years. 4+ years.
Just since you've been here?
No, we moved here from California 2.5 years ago, and I started playing back in California.
Well, we thank you for your time today, and enjoy the new facilities.
All right, thank you.
Drew Tucker, an avid pickleball player here at Sun City. And Drew, these are beautiful new facilities. Tell me what your reaction is and where you think we stand right now with the facility.
Well, we're very happy to be back on the South Courts, for one thing. With the South Courts open and two more courts here, living on the South Side, it's really convenient playing here. So it's a true pleasure, you know, and take the golf cart here rather than the automobile up to the north side.
Arjun Lakes,
yep. And so we're very happy with it. Right now it's a beautiful facility, you know, and when the bathrooms open, it'll be really nice.
Well, I've heard that comment before, and what's the pickleball club doing about the events that had to be canceled and the schedule from this point forward?
Well, the big tournament, it's very difficult to reschedule that because there are tournaments nationally all around the country. And so it was probably the best choice just to cancel it all together and then hope for next year's tournament in end of March or early April. And because otherwise you have conflicts with other tournaments going on, especially if fall tournaments are probably going to run as scheduled. So. Yeah, that was the best thing. Just cancel that and then resume next year.
And I assume the parking situation is much easier here.
Oh, the parking is wonderful with the golf carts here. That's wonderful. And the automobiles. Yeah, I always take my golf cart and it's perfect. You know, a couple minutes from home and I love it here on the South Side.
And how long have you been playing pickleball?
Well, I started in Arizona. I played for 5 years in Arizona. Moved here 2 years ago. And I just love this, the guys here and the facilities, and it's been a very good move for us.
You know? Now, you were down for, 3 months from playing pickleball, and so what's your takeaway from that layoff, anything?
Oh, no, it's easy to get back. It's like riding a bike, you know, you play for an hour and then you're sort of back in the groove, and so that wasn't a real problem, and but it was nice just to have something to do after that long layoff, though.
Well, thanks so much for your time, Drew. Go enjoy yourself.
All right, thank you.
We also visited with our Director of Golf Operations, Charlie Kent, to get updated on what has been going on at our golf courses.
Well, after a beautiful weekend at the Heritage, we are here at Hidden Cypress today to talk to golf professional Charlie Kent and Adam Gerlach about plans for the summer and beyond. And we hope to find out exactly what they're going to continue and what they're going to change. Should be interesting. Well, Charlie, we're here at Hidden Cypress today and talking to you a little bit about what's been going on in the previous months and the condition of the golf courses. How's it weathered?
Well, good morning. And it's been quite a fun ride at the golf courses. We got out ahead of the curve with the rules for safety for our residents, and the board approved our plan. We followed the guidelines of the golf industry across the country and implemented several practices to help with the social distancing. The most popular activity was to allow one person per cart, and here in Sun City, with everyone owning their own carts, we were not restricted by number of carts on the golf course. So we've allowed 4 carts per group, and as a result, pace of play has been amazing. Guys are playing in 3.5 hours. Normally it takes 4 hours and 10, 15 minutes. So that's been a real positive during this whole thing. And the buildings were closed, so we started checking golfers in outside, and that's worked out really well. There's no line. Folks just drive up, and we check them off that they're here, and then we charge them inside the golf shop later. So that's worked out really well as well.
One of the things I've really liked during this period is that check-in procedure makes it so easy. Are there any other of the adaptations that you made that you may be thinking about continuing, including in my case, widening the gimme circle to about 5 feet?
Well, you know, earlier in the year, the USGA approved allowing the flag stick to stay in. Actually, this was a year ago, but, you know, the flag sticks are staying in. We put those little, a little PVC pipe in the bottom of the cup to prevent the ball from going all the way down. It just kind of stays up near the top, so it's easier to pull out. So, you know, some of these things we're going to continue doing. I was just talking with a golfer a few minutes ago, and we're already trying to figure out how long the individual cart riding is going to go, and we all feel like it's probably going to last up into next year, into next spring, at a minimum. So we're going to come up with some options to allow for the good distancing on the course, but also, you know, we have to provide a good playing surface for the golfers. And you know, one of the downfalls of having so many carts riding on the ground is that the grass gets a lot of wear and tear on it. You know, these golf carts are heavy, and every time a cart rides across the ground, it's compacting it. So we just completed over the last several weeks, we just completed our annual maintenance of aerating the greens, and this year we went even harder with the tee boxes and the fairways. We verticut, we punched holes in the fairways, we put some sand out there on all the golf courses, and we'll be doing it all again come August. We do our second go around, and what we might see, you know, in between and into the fall, we may go out occasionally and punch some little holes just to open up the ground a little bit.
Right.
So you might see something like that later in the year to help the turf survive what we're doing to it.
Well, Charlie, that's a great summary, and you're always so kind to spend some time with us. Great information. Good luck with the rest of the summer and the fall.
Thank you very much, Doug, and let's keep on swinging out there.
Well, that's your update for this week. Thank you so much for watching. We invite you to check out Sun City TV's weekly program schedule in Sensations Magazine. And now check highlights and alerts on Twitter at SunCityTVHHI. Also, email us at suncityTVHH@gmail.com. Now, to see extended coverage of your favorite news segments, tune into Extra. Check the current Sensations magazines for daily times. Now, make sure you tune in next week to find out all the news that's happening in our community. But in the meantime, I hope your week is full of only good news. For Sun City News, I'm Norma Taylor, and I'll see you next week.